Who is the sane person, and what mechanism was that which allowed him to climb the pyramid of all living things and reach its summit? Where did we come from and where are we going? They are all questions that come to our minds from time to time. Some of us shorten the path on themselves and choose ready-made answers as provided by religions, while others turn to the authority of science in search of those answers that science itself acknowledges are answers that have not yet been completed. In his book, The Sane: A Brief History of the Human Race, the historian, Yuval Harari, chooses the authority of science as he combines various disciplines and scientific facts, such as development and the history of civilizations, to tell us our story. We, Homo sapiens, in a smooth manner far removed from the complexities of terms and concepts scientific. Yuval focuses on four milestones in human history: the Intellectual Revolution, which is estimated to have occurred 70,000 years ago, when language and myth were the undisputed weapon of Homo sapiens. This revolution led to the widespread of humans across the globe, and caused many imbalances and changes in the animal and environmental chains. Among the prominent and perhaps shocking ideas presented by Yuval is his categorical assertion that a person would not have reached what he had reached had it not been for the myths and stories that he created one day and believed in them, where he says, "The only difference between us and chimpanzees is that imaginary glue that is it connects huge numbers of individuals, families and groups. This glue has made us pioneers of creation. Humans will not agree unless they find something in common between them." Thus, religions, different ideological systems, human rights, money, etc. are nothing but fictitious mythical stories that serve the interests of groups and civilizations towards the goal of uniting them under the umbrella of one belief. The second Alakil station came 11,000 years ago, when the Intellectual Revolution led to the Great Agricultural Revolution, which spread in different parts of the world at a relatively close time. Where did you allow people to double their food, which led to a great explosion in the population? More than 90% of the calories that humans depend on today are the products of the few plants that our ancestors took care of in the midst of the agricultural revolution. Yuval argues that the agricultural revolution was not, never, a happy event in human history. Rather, it was a force that changed the world in a way that no one imagined or wanted, and that it raised the ceiling of our suffering, and even the suffering of most of the animals that our ancestors looked after. Living without contentment and relying entirely on a few plants made freedom a difficult dream to fulfill. The third stage is that long period in history, in which a great unification of groups and civilizations took place, and political systems were built that are still adopted until now. The author discusses many topics in this chapter, including what he stresses that social classes, racial and sexual discrimination are the actions of man only in order for him to better control the process of societies and systems, and also stresses that human civilization is rapidly approaching one global civilization, where will the states and rulers disappear. In the fourth axis, Yuval discusses the scientific revolution that began 500 years ago. It sheds light on the increasing human belief in the possibility of acquiring and discovering new powers through scientific research. This chapter also deals with the myth of capitalism, which the author considers a religion like all religions. The consumer view tells us that in order to live happy, we must consume products and services as much as possible. If we feel that there is something wrong or something not good, then we should buy a product, car, new clothes, organic food, or to request services from others, house cleaning service, psychological treatment for married couples, yoga lessons. Every advertisement you see is another myth that tells you that your consumption, or possession, of a product or service will make your life best. Yuval presents at the end of the book an objective vision of the future of Homo sapiens, whose end is almost approaching, as, through science and technology, he will create different and new dimensions of life, such as artificial intelligence, and he himself will become the god of smart design. However, he returns to remind us that the problem of the wise man, despite his strength, is that he does not know clearly what he wants. He does not know what he wants in order to want. Is there a more complex problem than an indignant, indifferent gods who do not even know what they want?